good morning, everybody. So this is my friend Stephanie Boy coming in from Philadelphia, and I'm here in Charleston, South Carolina, and we've been having these incredible private conversations that we feel like there's a million other people that are also in the same boat. We're here raising, between us, six teenagers and having a lot of conversations about how to talk to them about sexuality. Steph and I were raised the same, conservative Irish Catholic parents, and the messaging was like super clear.
Don't have sex. Can't be clearer than that.
Virgin till married. And a lot of, you know, Catholic guilt around sex, and, you know, it wasn't for pleasure. And, you know, I know my mother said to me 100 times, if you even think of having sex, you'll get pregnant. And there was a lot of, like, you know, that kind of stuff going on.
Cut to today.
Yeah. So Steph's daughter's 17, my daughter's 16. And, I really admire the way Stephanie is handling talking to sex with her kids. And I feel like I'm failing in this department. And I think the reason, I think I'm more the norm. I don't know what my messaging is.
Right.
I know that what my parents said is not the advice I want to give my kids. But I also know that the messaging they're getting all day long from society is whacked.
All right, let me just say, I think that we have to put the fear of the messaging that they're getting from society aside. It absolutely plays a huge role in this. But I don't think you can let that dictate how you talk to your kids about sex, right? Because it's super important. And, you know, our parents, no sex before marriage. What that did is it closed the door. And what does it close the door to? It literally closes the door to the single most valuable information and, you know, person that your children are ever going to be able to speak to about sex. There is nobody who loves them more than you. There's nobody who has their back more than you. And when you tell them this is not acceptable and you don't let them make decisions for themselves, and if they do, you're not accepting of them, then they will never be able to hear your wisdom in situations that are way over their heads sometimes, you know?
Yeah, it's so, true.
We have to remember that. And that's why it's super important.
And to have the conversation, but also to say, like, when you ask me the question, under what condition would you approve your daughter having sex? Does she know what that would be? Absolutely not. Okay, absolutely not. We have not had that conversation. I have not given that messaging.
Okay. So if we accomplish one thing in this phone call, it's to say, answer that question. And you can even ask that of your child, because they've definitely gotten messages from things that you've said around the house, whether you've directly talked about sex or you've talked about it a little, or in my case, you talk about it all the time and a lot, and however it comes up, I feel like it's important to address it. But no matter what, ask them that question. That's how you should start the conversation.
Yeah.
If you were to engage in sex, what would you think? How would I feel, or under what circumstances would I approve of that? And that sort of becomes like almost like your mission statement, if you will. I think that's important that we know that. And just to back this up, there is a study or a research, Dr. Lawrence Steinberg from Temple University did an article in Psychology Today. And studies show that teens, when asked where they prefer to get their information, from school or from their parents, 9 out of 10 say they prefer to get it from their parents. That says they want us to talk to them.
They do.
And that fear, the fear that you're gonna tell them that it's go willy-nilly into the world and have sex is unfounded.
The thing
that research shows is that teens who are informed are much more responsible. And when the largest faction of society that's getting sexually transmitted diseases is between 14 and 24, you need to be talking to your child about sex. They need to get that information from you.
I want to blow up the taboos. Let's continue the conversation in the next video, Steph.
Yeah. Taboo barbecue, baby.
I like it.
All right. So end of this is figure out what are your values and what you want to say to your kids. Get a clear message. Hmm.